Hi everyone, this is LAR Games, and today I'm watching episode 5 of Zoids. This one is called Transforming into Zero Jaeger. So I guess it's gonna transform this episode. Thanks, title. All right, let's get started. Does he have a similar head thing as the girl? Okay. Now I'm just imagining his room is just full of guns. Oh, a big city. Have we seen one of those before? He's trying really hard not to get hired. Okay. I'm surprised those previous guys met his standard in any way. All right, well, that's how he's getting into this. He could have looked at that. He pointed it at himself before turning it. He left the money. The money's still on the table, isn't it? So did he pay for them? Or did he just give them to him? Yeah, that's a very good idea. Oh. Shouldn't those things already exist? Well, and no arguing there. That's the highest priority, after all. You can tell these guys are true intellectuals. Glad I found you where you live. Though it is a pretty nice coincidence that he was just walking outside as he came. I like how he just doesn't display, like, he doesn't he doesn't say anything about the Lena thing. Perpetuating his misunderstanding. That's a pretty interesting derp face right there. Oh, it makes routers too, huh? No, I think that has more to do with that guy. Yeah, exactly. If he wasn't so goofy, he'd come off as like much worse. So apparently this mercenary guy is like really quick, so I guess the main character is going to beat him at his own game somehow, I feel. That's something very similar to something in Legend of Korra. Another inventor did a very similar thing to, for probably the same reason. Who coincidentally is also like the best character in the show. You okay, Varric? I'm very impressed he's able to do it in one night, though. So considering what a professional this guy is, I'm sure he looked into his opponents quite a bit. Because if not, well, I think they might be overpaying him. Or maybe not, considering they left the money on the They don't give people a lot of time to get out. I mean, that's what he was intending with the turtles. Seems these are televised. I call those explosions. That'd be a nice thing to tell the people actually participating in the fight. You mentioned that before. So you can do this during battle, huh? I wonder if like the enemy could just like destroy that before it's possible to do an upgrade mid-battle. Or maybe it's like a timeout. He looks a little happy there. I feel like in a competition of who's going to hit each other harder, Liger is the one with the advantage here because he has more mass. No, he really, really likes this. No wonder. Oh, they're doing that? One of them's gonna explode or fall or something. I guess. Oh. So, is he going to go back to like the regular form in the next battle, or is there a reason he just can't keep those upgrades? You kind of did that this time. Is that a thing? It means a lot of bread for everyone. Lately, it's since the very beginning. That's what he was signing. I was concerned back then, but I was wondering that myself. I think I may have said something about that. I hope I did. Because I did think it. All right, that was an interesting episode. We got to see like a more populous area of this planet, which I don't think they've named yet, have they? So it's not just one gigantic desert. There is a city area, but it would be nice to see more diversity in the landscapes. Though the fact that they're centered around this area probably means that that's not going to happen. It just make it easier for like the background artists and stuff. So that's probably not going to change anytime soon, for that reason as well. But yeah, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.